Chicago won the toss. The Bears will receive. Mason Crosby will kick off. And Chris Williams is back deep for Chicago. So temperature in the mid-30s. We had some light snow showers this morning. It's been dry since about 1 o'clock. Some more snow is expected tomorrow, but this one should be played in dry conditions. In the field at Lambeau, in very good shape. With Jared Allen talking about starting a winning streak tonight, if the Bears could do it and get to 4-5, Chicago has 5 of its next 6 games in Soldier Field. Of course, they're 0-3 at home, but sooner or later, you figure that's got to turn around. So the schedule would work in their favor. Here we go from Lambeau. And Williams from about 8 yards back to run it back, but not very far. Flag is thrown on the run back, Jared Bush, special teams maven for Green Bay, making the tackle. First year referee, though he's been in the league for a lot of seasons as an official, Craig Rolstad.
Illegal block in the back. Return team, number 59. The penalty's half the distance to the goal. First down.
Back him up inside the 10, and here's the Chicago offense.
Jay Cutler, Vanderbilt University.
Matt Forte, Tulane.
Brandon Marshall, Central Florida.
Alshon Jeffrey, South Carolina.
Joshua Morgan, Virginia Tech.
Martellus Bennett, Texas A&M.
Kamon Bushaw, Towson University.
Michael Ola, Hampton University.
Roberto Garza, Texas A&M Kingsville.
Kyle Long, Oregon.
Jordan Mills, Louisiana Tech University.
A lot of talent on that offense, but they're 13th in the league in yards and 18th in points scored, and they start on the ground with Forte, who goes to the 10-yard line. And right off the bat, Chris, we take a look at that Green Bay defense.
Yeah, a little strange here. We've got a big change. Clay Matthews now going to play the inside linebacker position. We told you that they could not stop the run of the Chicago Bears in the first game. So they're making this change to put Clay Matthews inside, trying to add a little beef in there.
Forte with a gain of 4, second down and 6. Play action, and they get the first down. The pass on the outside to Alshon Jeffrey. First down there, Sam Shields making the tackle. For Jay Cutler, still looking for his first victory here. Didn't play here when he was with the Broncos. He's 0-3 as a starter with the Bears and missed 2 games here because of injury. 2 touchdowns, 10 picks, and he's been sacked 15 times. House of horrors for him. From the 19. And the pass is caught by Josh Morgan. And he has a first down. Shields again covering on this play. That's a gain of 11 and a first down.
Gonna check out Sam Shields, who's been out for a couple of weeks with a sore knee, and going right after him. I've got to tell you, all I can find myself doing so far, though, is watching Clay Matthews. What does he know about dropping into coverage? What does he know about reading offensive linemen when they're pulling and doing? This is going to be quite a test for him.
Well, father and grandfather both played linebackers. They've been all over the field as well. There he is in the middle. And Cutler dancing, throwing, and it's incomplete. Trying to make a one-handed grab was Jeffrey. Let's take a look at that Green Bay defense.
Detroit Guyana, Bradford High School Tornadoes.
Mike Daniels, Highland Regional High School.
Mike Neal, Purdue University.
Clay Matthews, USC.
A.J. Hawk, The Ohio State University.
Julius Peppers, North Carolina.
Tremont Williams, La Tech.
Morgan Burnett, Georgia Tech.
Ha-ha Clint Dix, The University of Alabama.
Sam Shield, The U.
Micah Hyde, The University of Iowa.
Clinton Dix, their number one draft choice. Out of the pistol, here's Forte, and he'll go nowhere. Stopped behind the line of scrimmage. And that'll set up a 3rd and 11. Josh Boyd, number 93, makes the stop.
Josh Boyd right here, gonna come down and make this play, along with Julius Peppers on the other side. But that's exactly what they're hoping for Dom Capers, because now with Clay Matthews inside, now you just go to your normal five-man rush and wouldn't be surprised at all in most of these situations to see him just coming after Jay Cutler.
Forte had been split. Now he joins Cutler in the backfield. Packers show blitz, and they are coming. But the pocket is clean. Flag is thrown. Jeffrey makes the catch. He's 5 yards shy of a first down. And a penalty on the play. Get the call from
prior to the snap. Wilson. False start. Offense, number 74. Repeat. Third down.
So no play. Bushrod. The penalty is on him.
Well, here comes Clay Matthews doing what he does best. And they use this formation some, a lot in the nickel and dime situations. He will be the inside guy in that 3-2 set. So it's not like he hasn't played it at all. They just really felt like this gave them a chance to put their best 11 players on the field because they're strong at outside linebacker with Mike Neal, Julius Peppers, and Nick Perry.
Nick Bland carved out by Dom Capers, the defensive coordinator. Over the bye week. Now to the outside, here's Jeffrey, and he escapes one tackle, but then gets shoved out of bounds while shy of the first down as Clay Matthews knocks him out of bounds, and Chicago, after a couple of first downs, will have to punt.
And it's not like Matthews isn't going to be on the end of the line of scrimmage some. Obviously, very comfortable out there and really made the first down saving tackle on that one.
Punter is Patrick O'Donnell, a rookie. They drafted him in the sixth round. He's had an off and on season. Micah Hyde is back for Green Bay. And the kick is a low line drive and short kick that bounds out of bounds in front of the Chicago bench into the wind and out at the 29-yard line where Green Bay's ball. Here comes Rodgers. Sunday Night Football being brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Book your low fare now at southwest.com. By BMW, we only make one thing, the ultimate driving machine. By the North Face, never stop exploring. And by AT&T, mobilizing your world. It's a look at the USS Green Bay, commissioned in 2009. It's in San Diego right now. Helicopters land aboard the USS Green Bay, and they name the landing area Lambeau Field.
Of course.
From the 29, Rodgers on first down, checks down underneath, hits Lacy, puts his shoulder down, and takes a hard smack from Williams after a gain of 9. It'll be second and 1.
Well, we've been seeing this more and more on the outside. You've got Jordy Nelson, and he just wasn't open to the satisfaction of Aaron Rodgers, so he did what he did when we saw him against the Saints. A lot of checkdowns there to Eddie Lacy.
Quick snap on a second and 1, but the Bears are right there and alert, and Lance Briggs has missed the last 3 games with a rib injury, makes the stop. 20 touchdown passes for Rodgers in this ballpark since his last interception at home. Was not picked off last year at all here. Of course, he missed half the season with a collarbone fracture. He's thrown 20 TD passes since the last interception, which came in December of 2012 at Lambeau.
31-3 in his last 34 regular season games. That's pretty impressive.
That was after starting his career following Brett Favre leaving at 6-6. That's Nelson coming in motion to the inside. Play clock is at 1. They just do get it off, and Lacy will pick up the first down. So 3 straight carries for the number 2 draft choice last year, Eddie Lacy out of the University of Alabama.
You know, one thing that's always on your mind if you're a defensive team, when you get third down and less than 5, Aaron Rodgers is going to work that hard count. He was going hard trying to get the Bears to jump off sides, but they worked on it all week as well.
Now with a full house backfield. Off the play fake, look out from behind. Rodgers can feel it, steps up, throws. Complete, caught by Randall Cobb at the 40. Just tremendous instincts. You can see the Bears coming from behind, almost getting to Rodgers. Aaron just steps up that one step, fires 21 yards, first down.
Almost got there, and we're starting to see Jared Allen now look like himself. Had pneumonia earlier in the season. They're really hoping he can come back and have a big role in this one, along with Jeremiah Ratliff, who also did not play in the first matchup between these two.
Where y'all going? 5-5. They're going to 5-5. Green 18! Green 18!
Lacy behind Corliss. The tight end had lined up in the fullback's role. Gain of a couple. Let's take a look at the Green Bay starters.
Aaron Rodgers, Butte Community College.
Eddie Lacy, Alabama.
Jordy Nelson,
Kansas State.
Randall Cobb, Kentucky.
Drew Qualis, Penn State.
Richard Rogers, Cal Berkeley.
David Bakhtiari, Sarah High School.
Josh Sitton, Central Florida.
Corey Lindsley, The Ohio State.
TJ Lang, Birmingham Brother Rice.
Brian Belaga, Iowa.
That offensive line, the two guards banged up, but in there tonight. Second down and seven. 6 minutes into the game. This is Green Bay's first possession. And Rodgers has a lot of time and throws, and the catch is made by Jordy Nelson. That's a first down at the 20. Jennings makes the tackle.
Now both the offensive guards here dealing with injuries over here on the left side, a toe and an ankle for Josh Sitton and TJ Lang. And for this offense, to me, those two guys have always been the key. They have the ability to hold tight so Aaron Rodgers can step up and use his mobility skills.
Nelson, their top receiver, that's his 51st catch of the season. Toss to Lacy, looking for room, and cuts it back. Picks up five, gets to the 15. Here are the Chicago defensive starters.
Willie Young, North Carolina State University.
Jeremiah Rattler, Auburn.
Stephen Pia, Oregon State University.
Jared Allen, Idaho State.
Lance Briggs, Desert Swarm, Arizona.
DJ Williams, the U.
Trey McClellan, Boise State.
Tim Jennings, Georgia.
Ryan Mundy, Woodland Hills High School.
Chris Conley, Cal.
Kyle Fuller, Virginia Tech.
Fuller making a mark in his rookie year. First round draft pick. Pass caught on the outside by Qualis, and he will have enough for a first down. It'll be first and goal. Packers in the last game in Chicago didn't punt. Neither did Chicago, as it turned out. So the last nine drives, seven TDs and a field goal and a blocked field goal.
You know, it's unbelievable. Five touchdowns, a field goal in the first six possessions. Only three times in 20 years has that happened. And it happened against the Bears and what used to be a great defensive unit.
First and goal. Inside the 10. Quickly to Nelson. Tries to get a block. And Cobb is able to screen the defender off and let Nelson pick up another couple of yards to about the 3. Second and goal.
Well, these receivers are really good blockers. You'll see Randall Cobb coming to the outside, a slip on the edge by Tim Jennings, and they're lucky that didn't score. But somehow the Bears have to begin to believe they can stop the Packers offensively, because they just have not done it thus far at all.
Second and goal. This is the 10th play of the drive. And a little toss into the end zone, and Qualis started to go to the outside, and the pass was thrown to the inside. Mundy covering. It'll be third down and goal for the Packers.
I really thought Andrew Qualis there could have jumped back through the defender and probably gotten the call. There's Mel Tucker on the sideline, and they really felt like that they wanted to get back and simplify some things, that maybe they had gone too far and wanted to just allow the guys to play a little faster defensively. The problem is Aaron Rodgers is playing faster than that.
That Bear defense, 22nd overall in the league and 29th in points allowed. Third and goal. Play clock at 3. And he has to take a timeout to avoid delay of game. So Rodgers will discuss it with McCarthy briefly. Mike, one of the few head coaches in the league, Sean Payton would be another, who calls the plays. When these two guys meet head-to-head in the regular season, well, it's one-sided. It's all tilted to the right side there. 8-1 is Aaron Rodgers. 16 TDs and 6 picks to Cutler with 12-19. But some of that goes back to Jay in Denver. Comes to Chicago in 2009. Gets him to a championship game along the way where they lost to Green Bay.
But let's face it, Jay Cutler was brought to Chicago to beat Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers, and he just has not been able to do it.
Heavy left, heavy left.
Third down goal from the 4. Stack Corliss in the backfield. Lacy stays in the block. Then he goes into the pattern, makes the catch at the 5, and bulls his way to the 1 yard line. So Lacy was there initially to block, rolls out, to the right, takes the pass, and now it's fourth and goal from the one, and they're going to send in the field goal group.
Ryan Mundy, the leading tackler for the Chicago Bears, just made a tremendous play. Eddie Lacy, about 235 pounds of him, went nowhere but straight down upon contact. Looked like he slipped just a bit, too.
No field goal group now. They started out, and then the offense came back out. Lacy is there. Kuhn is the fullback on fourth and goal. Off the play fake. Pass is caught for a touchdown on a fourth down by Brandon Bostic, the number three tight end.
Always so difficult. The corner out here trying to cover a crossing route. He has to come all the way across the field there. And because you're playing the run as well as the pass, you've got to maintain that outside edge. But what do? You need a little help from Shea McClellan there with a shot on the tight end. Didn't get it.
A drive that consumes close to 6 minutes, 71 yards, 12 plays. Ran it four times, threw it eight times, and score on fourth down. Crosby at a match day's hold for the extra point. So Green Bay's first drive culminates, get a Packer touchdown. 7-0 Green Bay at Lambeau Field. NBC Sports Live Extra. Don't miss a moment of Sunday night football. Take the game with you anywhere, online and on tablet. All kinds of history. You walk into this place, home of the Packers for 58 years, formerly known as City Stadium, and then after the death of Curly Lambeau, named in his honor. A couple of yards deep, Chris Williams out of the end zone, and we'll bring it back to about the 20. So Lombardi, there is Curly Lambeau outside Lambeau Field. When these teams last met week four, September the 28th, the Bears rushing 41 times. They carried the ball for 235. And almost all of the runs were between the tackles. 37 runs for 203. One reason, of course, that Mr. Matthews has moved to the middle. Despite that, despite all of those yards, despite 496 total yards that day, they scored only 17 points and lost the game by 21.
It has been an issue, and we'll get into it in a bit, but the big plays for the Chicago Bears just have not been there this year the way they were a season ago.
Butler with a deep drop and a lot of time, and he's going to air it out. The gunslinger throws, and it's incomplete. Good double coverage. Josh Morgan, the intended receiver, and a flag is now down at the 32-yard line. All the way down to the 32. And Rolstad making his way toward the other officials, and you see Clinton Dix saying, it can't be on me.
There's no foul on the play as the action was legal.
All right.
I didn't even see any action. There wasn't anything there. I mean, that's, yeah. Whatever. I think good no call. How about that?
Morgan trying to avoid the interception.
But you can see how hard they're working in the running game. Matt Forte, despite all the yardage, doesn't have one over 20 yards. Brandon Marshall, just one catch over 20 yards. I mean, this has been, for an offense that was so explosive a year ago, just big issues for them this year.
Second and 10. And Cutler throws, and that's picked off at the 30-yard line by Micah Hyde. He returns it to the 24. So Jay Cutler, and we talked about his woes in this place, has just thrown a pick to set Rodgers up deep in Chicago territory.
Well, you know that Martellus Bennett missed practice on Friday. We were there. I talked to him. He thought he could go ahead and give it a shot and play. But this Micah Hyde, who has sort of bounced around between safety and corner and probably is best at a little hybrid position, comes up with another big play, and that ball just came floating out from Jay Cutler. We're used to seeing him throw rockets.
Micah Hyde in his second year, fifth-round pick out of Iowa. It's his first career interception.
There we go. ago, maybe Julius Peppers just got a fingertip on it and caused it to just float enough for Micah Hyde to get there. Still plenty athletic is Julius Pepper, the old basketball player from back in college.
Several years with the Panthers, then to Chicago. And now in his dotage, his football dotage, anyway, here. And Rodgers flips it to the outside. It's caught there by Devontae Adams, good-looking rookie out of Fresno State, where they have Nelson, they have Cobb, and then in the second round, they went after this guy, Adams. 21 consecutive touchdown passes at home without a pick. Talked about he hasn't been picked off here since December of 2012. Hard, tough runner to the 10 game of three. Jonathan Bostic in on the tackle. It'll be second down and seven.
Well, one of the guys that has really stood out here lately has been sort of the surprise. Corey Linsley is a rookie who kind of found out right before the opener he was going to be the starter, and now he's done so well, the guy they presumed to be the center, J.C. Treader, can't displace him. He has had a very good year, an excellent run blocker.
Linsley, fifth round pick out of Ohio State. Second and seven. Coon at fullback. And they give it to him through the middle, and the crowd loves the chant. Coon takes it to the 4 yard line. Good gain there for the fullback, chugging his way for a gain of six and making it third down and one.
Well, it's going to be third down and one, and as we have learned in the past, Aaron Rodgers will try to pick up this first down the easy way by getting the Bears to jump off sides. The Bears really spent all week in practice with Jimmy Clausen working hard at trying to discipline this defense, so we'll see how it goes.
Something that happens with great regularity at Lambeau Field has through the years with Favre and now with Rodgers. Play fake, rolling out, on the run, throws, caught, touchdown, Andrew Corliss.
Well, if you had any doubts about Aaron Rodgers' hamstring, no more. He is simply going to outrun. There's that Willie Young, who's probably the most athletic of these defensive ends, leads them in sacks, and Aaron Rodgers just hit the jets on that one.
Corliss with his third touchdown of the season. So two drives, two touchdowns, and Mason in to make it 14 to nothing. The interception, the turnover leading to a short field. Four plays, 23 yards, took 2 minutes, 14-0 Green Bay. The CIA detects countless threats. Only she decides which ones are real. From the director of the Blacklist, Kevin Heigl returns to television. State of Affairs, premiering Monday, November the 17th, here on NBC. As you look at the World War II Memorial in our nation's capital on this weekend before Veterans Day. Crosby's kick, returnable. The yard in, Chris Williams cuts it back. Tackle to the 15. Good special teams coverage by the Packers. They're doing a nice job all season long. 3:46 in the quarter. 14-0. Home team. Mark Trestman, second year as the Bears head coach. His pedigree is offense. And right now his offense has been stymied on its first two drives on this 34-degree night. And they start drive number three from the 15-yard line. Trying to get something going on the ground, but not here. Spinning around is Forte, but knocked down at the line of scrimmage, second and 10.
Yeah, I think Clay Matthews doing just fine so far inside. Here he's making the read. And the thing that you love about Clay Matthews is just how active he is. Whether he's pass rushing or whether he's playing the run, you always see those feet moving. He is always in just perpetual motion. And that time, he just sort of danced around. And you wonder how long it's going to take him to really figure out this position. And when he does, look out.
I think he already has a PhD in it.
It's pretty good.
Second and 10. Cutler throws, caught at the 20. That's Brandon Marshall to the 21. So a short pass to Marshall. Chris was talking about the big plays last year, but this year, Cutler on passes more than 20 yards from scrimmage, 8 of 31. And to Brandon Marshall, last year, 11 catches more than 20 yards from the line of scrimmage. This year, halfway through the season, 1 at Atlanta, period.
He's been hurt. That's been a big part of this. But at some point against this team, you have to get it going, and they have not thus far.
Third down and 3 from the 21-yard line. And Cutler throws. That's caught. And Marshall will pick up the first down, taking the ball to the 34-yard line.
Just get physical on the outside. He's way bigger than Sam Shields. Here he goes. All right, Brandon Marshall, just go to work, and you better go to work fast because Clay Matthews is coming right up the gut. Remember, Dom Capers used to be a coordinator for the Pittsburgh Steelers, and that blitz is one you used to see all the time for the Steelers.
From the 34-yard line. And Cutler with a flag thrown, double coverage. Alshon Jeffrey was the intended receiver. Shields and Burnett were back there. Here comes the call from Rolstad.
Illegal hands. Hands to the face. Defense, number 53. It's a 5-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
On Perry, number 53, Nick Perry.
Right here, once you go to the head just like that, they're not going to allow you to maintain that leverage. That is way too long. And it used to be you could kind of take a shot to the head and then get your hands down. Even that rule is gone. But Nick Perry is a big reason why they felt like they could move Clay Matthews inside. He's second on the team with 3 sacks behind only Julius Peppers.
From the 39 is Forte. So Chris, go figure, 3 games at Soldier Field, including the opener against Buffalo when they were heavily favored, 0-3, 3-2 on the road. Any common denominator for you?
The Green Bay Packers and what they can do to this team. I think that confidence-wise, that when a division rival takes you apart the way that this team has, and they beat them in the last game to go to the playoffs last year, that confidence-wise, you have to start finding something to believe in. And the easiest thing to believe in is your quarterback, Jay Cutler. And so I think that Jay Cutler has to find a way to take over this football team and start making big plays.
And here he sets up a screen, but the pressure was put on and nothing's happening. Mike Daniels put the heat on. It'll be 3rd down and 7.
And he's going to have to learn how to drop in coverage already tonight. He's probably cost himself 3 or 4 different pass rushes that he ordinarily would have. Little screen tried to sneak by him there, but he's seeing things from a whole different angle playing inside. But I got to tell you, I like this. This reminds me of what Dick LeBeau does with the Pittsburgh Steelers, where you're just as likely to get rushes from the inside linebackers as you are from the outside linebackers.
Play clock at 1, play clock at 0, and there's a flag thrown, delay of game.
Delay game, offense, number 6, 5-yard penalty, still 3rd down.
You know, Chris, there aren't too many secrets in this league. Do you think the Bears knew that Matthews was going to play on the inside tonight?
I don't. They really, and this is a coaching staff that generally tries to let us in on what's going to happen so we don't get surprised by anything. Mike McCarthy was not telling us this. We had to find out our own devious ways by actually going to practice. Wasn't all that devious.
3rd and 12, and Cutler's going to get slung to the ground by Matthews. Inside, outside, doesn't matter where he comes from. And Long and Peppers get into it. Teammates last year. Flag down. Cruz had a busy first quarter with the penalties.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, offense, number 67, blow to the face. That's a 15-yard penalty. The down counts. Fourth down.
Jordan Mills. Another punt from deep in their own territory.
Well, what do you do when you have your best player on the inside and best player on the outside? Just makes Jermon Bushrod look horrible there. Then that's a two-time Pro Bowler. And Matthews really seems to be energized by this, don't you think, Al?
Yes, definitely.
I mean, he just looks like he's having fun. He's getting to play going both directions at the line of scrimmage, playing the run. He's dropping back in coverage. This looks like a good move so far.
You can't have a better quarter than Matthews has had in this one. McDonald the kick. His first one was a short kick of 37. It's a much better one. Cobb is back. And Cobb will get taken down by about three white shirts at the 27-yard line. 22 seconds remaining in the opening quarter. Tonight's aerial coverage being brought to you by Geico. Bears Packers doing it since 1921. Lambeau Field. No empty sheets here for a long, long time.
Some formal cheese up there. I'm used to, you know, a little triangle.
Brie, Camembert, you name it. America's Dairyland.
It's a nice place, though. I tell you, out of all the stadiums, you walk in here and everybody says hi and makes you feel like you're one of the neighbors.
Howdy, partner. In the 28. First down. Seconds of the quarter. Rodgers to the left side. That pass is incomplete. Lacy out in the flat. It'll be second down and 10.
One of the things the Packers wanted to do was see, coming off the bye, how the Bears would react to some of these different formations. So we saw them go a little too tight end stuff early on, multiple backs in the backfield, now a little bit more of the spread formation. But we've also seen some of these other weapons now really step up. Devontae Adams, Richard Rodgers, Eddie Lacy all had their biggest games ever receiving in the last one. So now what do you do trying to defend these guys?
Here's Lacy on a draw. And gets upended just about at the line of scrimmage, and that's going to take us into the second quarter. So the Green Bay Packers score on their first two drives. We've played one at Lambeau. It's 14-0 Green Bay, and Sunday Night Football continues after these messages. Second quarter, Green Bay, Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Michelle DeFoya. Packers at home, three games this year, 31, 42, and 38. And already 14 tonight as we start the second quarter. Third down and 11 for Green Bay from the 27-yard line. Four-man rush. Good protection. Lots of time. Wide open. Jordy Nelson turns it back inside. Jordy Nelson to the end zone. Lambeau leap to follow.
After trying to get the hard count twice, little hand signal out to Jordy Nelson, and then promptly the Bears blow the coverage. They've got a safety in the middle of the field, nobody covering on the outside, and for Jordy Nelson, so far every game this year at the Packers have played at home, he's got one for over 50 yards and a touchdown and make it four now.
That was Brock Vereen, rookie from Minnesota, in the middle. The deep safety. Nelson turned it back inside on him. Goes all the way. 73 yards on a third and 11. Three possessions and three touchdowns for the Green Bay Packers. And it's 21-0. Well, Lovie Smith gone after last year. Last two seasons under Trestman, in effect, a year and a half. 24 games, 700 points allowed. 7 yards per play. That's next to worst in the NFL. and 144 rush yards, 5 per carry, last in the NFL. David Hahn, the Chicago Tribune, was writing a column that is very interesting, talking about, you know, the Bears coaches and, you know, Trestman, and got off to a good start last year, 3-0 in the history of the Bears coaches. Of course, everybody knows about George Halas. They love Mike Ditka. But remember, Neil Armstrong was the coach for 4 years. He, like Trestman, had come out of the CFL. Not a very good start for him. He lasted about 4 years. And one columnist got so tired of Armstrong, he once wrote, as I recall, in Neil's fourth year, they sent the wrong Neil Armstrong to the moon. that was cold.
That's cold. Although, they might be sending a few of these Bears to the moon here pretty soon. This is downright embarrassing. This is a proud franchise that's being humiliated so far here tonight.
3 yards in, Chris Williams. Run back to about the 18-yard line, and here's the touchdown by Nelson, his seventh of the season.
Well, here's the coverage. There's nobody over there. There's only a single safety. You got locked up here. You got to think that you're going to be one-on-one there. There's nobody else that could possibly get there. I just assume that Tim Jennings thought it was a different coverage. Got Brock Vereen, the young rookie back there. Maybe he messed up the call. You never know for sure. But Lovie Smith would be having a stroke right now, because they never gave up plays like that where it was just freebies. They always made you go 10, 12 yards to try and get a touchdown.
From the 19, Cutler's going to go deep, and not even close, really. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver, second down and 10. 16 career touchdown passes of 70 or more yards, most in the history of the league for a guy in his 10th season, but played behind Favre for three of those, so really became a starter in 08.
But that was third and 11. Third and 11. Mm-hmm. Now, you know, you can't do that. Aaron Rodgers is unbelievable. Jordy Nelson is unbelievable. I don't want to take anything away from them, but you can't be that bad.
Second and 10. Pass is caught by Jeffrey, and he gets tackled at the 20-yard line by Micah Hyde.
Everybody got all over Brandon Marshall because he went crazy in the locker room after one of their home losses, and I'm not so sure there haven't been enough tirades like that with this football team. There seems to be a little bit of a acceptance. You know, you watch them, and I mean, this is your biggest game of the year. This is it. This is number one. You don't win here, you're pretty much out of any playoff shot, and you get this.
And you get it off a bye week, too. Week of rest, because Green Bay's coming off a bye as well, and that's incomplete. Fourth down, just like that. Grim. Cutler is 6 of 12 for 50 yards, and on the ground where they would have to win the game tonight. Forte, 4 carries, 6 yards. The rookie O'Donnell. This is his third punt of the night. Cobb from the 30. Always dangerous. Good run back here, almost to midfield. Out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Look at a couple of guys whose team is up by 3 touchdowns. Bears and Packers, and there's a lot of history. And some of the biggest names, of course, Lombardi and Halas. 188 regular season meetings, 188 tonight, 2 playoff meetings. Very close. 92-89, and the Packers right now looking like they're headed for 90. 6 games have wound up as ties, each team with the same number of touchdowns. It's been that close through the years coming in. And you think about these two teams, they met twice in the playoffs, once the week after Pearl Harbor, and then back in the 2010 season when Green Bay won the game, went on to win the Super Bowl. From the 46 on first down, James Starks now as Eddie Lacy gets a rest for the first time tonight. 8-5.
One of the hard parts about defending Aaron Rodgers is that he does not have to have his feet set in order to deliver the football and deliver it accurately. I mean, that's a throw that not many people can make, but the strength of his arm, you see just little flicks, almost like, you know, I would throw a piece of paper in a garbage can next to my desk or something. He just can kind of flick the football and see it come rifling out of there. Look at the numbers already against a team that is relatively healthy now on the defensive side of the ball.
And Rodgers' hamstring is more than relatively healthy. Looks perfect.
Yeah, that run to the outside was a good sign.
The bye week came at a dead right time. Here's Nelson. That'll be a first down. And he gets forced out of bounds by Tim Jennings.
Yeah, I think the only thing that Aaron Rodgers was worried about was that Mike McCarthy is going to make him stay here and take treatment during the bye week. He said, oh, no, it feels good. I'm going to be good. He took his program wherever he went off to and came back on Monday. Said he was, thought he was a little tentative, obviously a little nervous about that hamstring, but by later in the week, he was just Aaron Rodgers, and that's exactly what we're seeing out here tonight.
You better get on the program. At the 40. Play action. Pressure on. Look at him stepping up and feeling it, but then the ball comes loose as he was getting tackled from behind. It's incomplete. Ratliff had gotten to him, but he was able to get rid of it. Incomplete.
Definitely Aaron Rodgers flicking that ball. There's Jeremiah Ratliff here, who comes up and gets a little pressure working
against
Josh Sitton.
There's no intentional grounding. 44 was the intended receiver.
Now you could see a receiver in that area, and clearly Aaron Rodgers taking the ball and flipping it forward. Great job by him, taking care of not giving up the sack for Josh Sitton. That's really the first sign that I've seen that he's having maybe a little bit of a problem with that toe injury. Got pushed back on that one, and the Bears were really hoping that Jeremiah Ratliff could have a major impact on one of these two guards, because they're both playing with relatively significant injuries. Toe injury for Josh Sitton, ankle injury for TJ Lang.
You'd never know it. Second and 10. Deep, open, caught. Touchdown, Jordy Nelson. Two touchdown catches for him tonight. 40 yards here into the stands for the Lambeau Leap he goes. He's already gained 142 receiving yards tonight.
Just straight down the field. Now you're hoping the safety, as Aaron Rodgers is going to his right, Ryan Mundy is going to begin to lean that way. You certainly don't think that when he's rolling this way, you're going to be able to squeeze in on a double coverage on a cover two where the safeties are split. You should not be able to get that ball in there. I mean, that is just the recognition on the part of Mundy that he has to have. And that's not even close.
If you're a Bears fan right now, are you more flipped off at the offense or the defense?
I'm sorry. I was watching something, trying to figure out how that happened to him.
Well, the question was, you're more flipped off at the offense or the defense if you're a Bears fan. I think it's an equal opportunity situation.
The answer is yes. Sorry.
Special teams, but okay. Here's Crosby for the point after. Oof. 3 minutes into the second quarter. 28-0 on Sunday Night Football. All right, on Saturday, the Fighting Irish, they're back home in South Bend, ready to take on Northwestern. You'll see it. Notre Dame Saturday coverage beginning 3 Eastern time right here on NBC. 28-0, the Packers on top early in the second quarter. From the 10, Chris Williams to the 25-yard line. That Bear defense. Ooh, boy.
Simplest of cover twos here. So this guy's going to go around, and you just, as the quarterback comes this way, you just drift over and make a play. There's no way you get this ball in there. None, and they're not even close. Ryan Mundy's not even close. I mean, that's first day of training camp kind of coverage. Great play by Jordy Nelson and Aaron Rodgers, but come on.
There's the premium on defense, getting better on defense in the offseason. Matt Forte there is his first good run of the night. Winds up with a lot of mud and grass on his helmet.
Clay Matthews is going crazy. He's running through the line of scrimmage and then running down Matt Forte. Now that's playing with passion. He was just running through his gap, had that under control, and then just never changed gears and ran down the best back that the Bears have.
Gain of 13 and a first down at the 40-yard line. Trying to end around Jeffrey. As he gets by Burnett, there's a flag. Burnett may have gotten the face mask. Ha-ha, Clinton Dix is there as well. And a flag thrown as he was knocked out of bounds.
You know, Clinton Dix likes to put on some big hits. Sometimes he tries too hard and will miss a tackle or hit one out of bounds.
Personal foul. Defense, number 21. Unnecessary roughness. 15-yard penalty. Added end run. Automatic first down.
There used to be a time in this series between these two teams, there was no such thing as unnecessary roughness. It was all necessary. And Clinton Dix is one of those guys, they really like him. They like his physical style. He has a way of getting down around the line of scrimmage, helping with the run game. And so he's just growing in what he's doing. But a very physical presence that they think is going to be very good here for a long time.
Given a Hasheen, nicknamed by his grandma. Ha-ha Clinton Dix, one of the great names. In football to the outside, Jeffrey. To the 30-yard line for a gain of 8. A.J. Hawk making the tackle.
This was supposed to be a team that was loaded on offense, right, Al? I mean, they've got everybody went to the Pro Bowl at one time or another. Brandon Marshall, Alshon Jeffrey, Matt Forte, Jay Cutler, Martellus Bennett. I mean, you don't get better skill guys than that. And yet, at least so far, got nothing to show for it. And this is a team in the Green Bay Packers that ranked dead last in run defense. At least they did before they put Clay Matthews back inside.
Second down and 2, and here goes Forte. He picks up a first down. So Chicago needs to get something going. First good drive of the night to the 25-yard line. Forte, a guy who, a 3-down back, outstanding runner, great pass receiver, and he's been doing it for 7 years now. Bears got him out of Tulane, second round in 08.
That's a chance to blow away the all-time record for receiving for a running back. I think the record's about 102. He's on pace for around 116.
A little toss this time. Forte getting around the corner. And a gain of about 4 before he is forced out of the 21-yard line. Second down and 6 for Chicago. We had those offensive stars, and of course Trestman was hired for his offensive acumen, longtime offensive coordinator in the National Football League, assistant coach. Went up to Montreal, had a lot of success there. And Phil Emery and the search party locked in on him with Cutler's approval. They brought Cutler into the process when they were looking for head coach. Second down and 6. Play clock at 1. Toss to Forte. Forte will be taken down at the 7-yard line. Got by Hawk. Sam Shields makes the tackle. First and goal.
This is what makes Forte so dangerous coming out here, because if you give him a little space, a guy like A.J. Hawk generally is not going to be able to bring him down in the open field. He is not the fastest running back in the league. He's not the biggest. He's not the strongest. But he can do a little bit of everything. The one thing we've had him struggle with a little bit over the years is in pass protection. And I was wondering if they'd be able to isolate Matthews on Forte in this game. Haven't seen it yet.
Bringing the rookie back here, Kadeem Carey out of Arizona. Fake it to him, and then Cutler will throw halfway into the bleachers. Jeffrey in the area, second down and goal.
I don't know what they're doing. If that's supposed to be a slant, okay. If it's supposed to be a fade to the corner, okay. But it's neither. It is. Al, you tell me what that is.
You played receiver. You don't know?
I ran a few like that, but
nobody
I still
knows.
Don't know what it
yeah.
is.
It's just a lousy play. Second and goal from the six. Forte back in. He has the ball. And then they're going to have a third down and goal. This is not a drive that you want to have in with 3 points.
Well, at this point, could you even afford to kick a field goal?
No, I don't think you do.
I don't think you do either. I think this is all or nothing here. You, at the very least, leave them backed up here. But, you know, this is a very good red zone team. I mean, you would expect them to be. They don't run it a lot down here. They pass it more than anybody, and why not? And they've got an NBA team on the outside. Brandon Marshall, Martellus Bennett, Alshon Jeffrey, big guys. Give him a chance. Now they even include Forte. He's flanked out.
He's wide right. Inside of him is Jeffrey. Marshall on the other side. And Butler has to take a timeout. So that'll make it a third and goal. Next Sunday, week from tonight, Sunday Night Football is beauty. Each of these teams is off today, and Tom Brady and Andrew Luck, a pair of 12s going at it. Thanksgiving night, it is San Francisco and Seattle. Next week, Arizona, it's Indianapolis against New England. Points per game, Indy leading the league, Denver just behind, and then come the Patriots. Colts, Patriots from Indianapolis a week from tonight. All right, so after the timeout, third down and goal for Chicago. Different formation as they come up this time. And the pass is incomplete as Bennett can't hold on. Trailed by the linebacker Sam Barrington, and it's fourth down and goal, and the offense is going to stay in there.
Well, you got to hope that your big guy on the outside can catch this and put it in the end zone, and that's kind of how it's been going tonight. Martellus Bennett's really having a good year. Only Rob Gronkowski has more catches than he does coming in, and so far nothing.
And he had a big day in the first meeting between these teams in September. So it's fourth and goal, 8 minutes to go in the half from the five. 2 seconds, 1 second, they just do get it off, and then the pass is almost intercepted. Sam Shields was right there, not even close. Play clock at one, almost delay a game, get it off, bog down, turn it over on downs, 28-0. In an already pretty spectacular career, it's the first time that Aaron Rodgers has had 4 touchdown passes in the first half, and he still has almost 8 more minutes to pick up 1 or 2 more. Takes over after Chicago can't move it in. Handed over on downs. The ball at the 5-yard line and a first down. Cobb in motion. And here is Lacy. Mike McCarthy, as we mentioned before, one of the few coaches, head coaches in the league, who calls in his own plays. Speaker in Rogers' helmet, just like that. The green dot behind it calls in the play. Of course, Aaron can do what he wishes once he gets to the line.
The interesting part about that is the coaches can actually coach a little bit for that 15 seconds. Tell them what they want them to look for.
Second down and 8. Look at that time. Nobody can extend the play quite like Aaron these days. And there's Cobb to the 37-yard line. A little dancing and darting around a little bit, and sooner or later somebody's going to get open.
I always think that Aaron Rodgers looks a little like a hovercraft back in the pocket. He just sort of glides around. His feet never really get set in any one position, and eyes always down the field. And more often than not this year, it has been Randall Cobb, the former quarterback at the University of Kentucky, that just keeps finding a way to get open on those scramble drills.
Rodgers has already thrown for 225. Lacy darts through a big hole and then backs his way into Chicago territory. And we go to Michelle.
Well, Al, I'm speaking to you through the same radio system that Michael Karski communicates to Aaron Rodgers with. The speaker of Rodgers' helmet starts when the 40-second play clock begins and shuts down when it gets to 15. Now, they brought these speakers and this communication system into the league in 1994 to sort of modernize the game. The defenses didn't get the speakers till 2008, 14 years later, Al.
I tell you what, they need to modernize some of those walkie-talkies, don't they?
Wow, a whole game of that.
From the 48-yard line to the 40 goes Lacy for a gain of 8 and got a penalty.
I have even more respect for Aaron Rodgers now.
Holding, offense, number 75. 10-yard penalty, replay, first down.
Brian Bulaga.
Well, Brian Bulaga right here on the outside is going to get Willie Young, and then right at the last second you see the jersey pull there. I really thought that Willie Young might give this Bears defense a little bit of a lift. He had 7 sacks on the year, a very active guy, just kind of arms and legs flying everywhere. Of course, took over for Lamar Houston. They paid big money for Houston and Jared Allen and have not gotten big production out of them. And now Young in a little bit more of a full-time role, but in a game like this, hard to have much of an impact.
Yep. 319.
And Rodgers' pass is caught by Richard Rodgers. 3 pick out of Cal.
Yeah, he was a slot receiver at Cal, and really has, in the last few games, started to emerge. But the thing that they're most excited about with Richard Rodgers, yes, he had his best receiving day against New Orleans when we saw him last, but they like what he's doing blocking because they really haven't had that blocking tight end for a while.
Screen, plenty of blocking. Look at that blocking for Lacy. And he exploits it. And then picks up more blockers and goes all the way for a touchdown. 56 yards. You're going to draw up a screen in a clinic, you draw that one.
Same thing he did against New Orleans, right? Went about 60 with that one. Watch these big guys all get out in front. Bad toes, bad ankles, rookie. It doesn't make any difference. And they get it done on the outside. And this Eddie Lacy now, I don't know what you do. If this Packers offense has 8 different receivers to throw it to, and you can hit screen passes like that, what do you do? You know, maybe you don't come out after halftime. I don't know. But Eddie Lacy, I tell you what, he is getting better and better and better in this offense.
Extra point by Crosby. Well, last week we were in Pittsburgh where Ben Roethlisberger threw 6 touchdowns. Tonight, in less than a half, Aaron Rodgers has thrown 5. 35-0. In honor of Veterans Day, for every point scored during the NFL's 32 Salute to Service games, the league will donate $100 to each of its nonprofit partners, the Pat Tillman Foundation, USO, and Wounded Warrior Project. To join the salute and learn more, visit NFL.com/salute. Bagram Air Force Base in Afghanistan. Boys were looking on, watching the Cowboys earlier. There's the tribute to former Arizona Cardinal Pat Tillman. They've already, thanks to the Packers, contributed $3,500 in tonight's game. 35-0 to the 23-yard line. Well, for Phil Emery, who took over 3 years ago and then let Lovie Smith go after 9 seasons and brought in Mark Trestman, this has to be about as grim as it can get, coming off a game in New England 2 weeks ago before the bye where they gave up 51 points.
That may be a small number here tonight, you know, and Lance Briggs, when we were talking with him some, and he said, this is not Lovie's defense, you know, this is not the one gap flying up the field, punching balls out, preaching turnovers, this is not that.
Oh, and that's knocked down in the middle of the field. Burnett, and we go to Michelle.
Well, right tackle Jordan Mills is questionable with a rib injury, so another bit of shuffling on the Bears offensive line. Michael Olah goes to goes to right tackle, and Brian De La Puente moves to left guard. You know, Al, six different offensive line combinations already this season for the Chicago Bears.
You know, problems everywhere you look, Michelle, these days. Defense, offense, you name it, and it's all coming to a head in the last couple of games. Forte around the corner.
Well, they actually talked about leaving Michael Ola at right tackle this week. Jordan Mills had some problems with his foot, missed the last one, and played pretty well out there. And then Matt Slauson got hurt, and so they didn't think it was fair to ask Jordan Mills to go into left guard and go from a right-handed stance to left-handed stance and all. So they left it alone. But now that Jordan Mills is hurt, they take Ola back out to tackle, and De La Puente, really, you almost think more of as a center now playing guard, so this is becoming a mess quickly.
Third and five. Butler. And that's caught. And taken off with it is Bennett into Packer territory. And Martellus Bennett out of bounds at the 35-yard line.
Well, that's a nice play by Jay Cutler. That one sort of looked a little like Aaron Rodgers buying enough time and then just flipping it out there. Good ad lib on the part of Martellus Bennett. I don't think he could believe how open he's kind of looking around, saying, where are all these guys? But watch Cutler here. Just staying alive and then flipping it down the field. It really breaks down zone defenses. The more that quarterback can buy time and move around. Martellus Bennett had a huge game against the Bears last time, but not 100% out here tonight.
That was good for 37.
Oh!
Just stuffed Chris Williams by Clay Matthews. That'll make a few highlight tapes.
That's called ouch. Here we go. A little stunt here. He's going to come up around. And what do you think Chris Williams was thinking? You had to stunt that time? Oh, my goodness. What a first half. What a revelation it's been. Clay Matthews and Aaron Rodgers just laughing at him.
We're not going to flex out of the second half, are we? Second and 18. And a timeout. 2:44
wow.
To the half. Started by moving Matthews inside the night. Normally an outside linebacker in the middle. That's worked perfectly. The defense has been great. The offense has been over the moon. And it's 35 zip. 2:44 to the half. Second and 18. And that's knocked down at the line of scrimmage.
I've heard of slow starts before, Al, but in the last three games in the first half, 87-7 has been the score with the Bears. Here comes Julius Peppers inside. We told you about him playing a little basketball, and that's a rejection of the highest order.
Third and 18. Caught by Bennett, and he's out of bounds, well shy of the first down. Chris, in all seriousness, if you're the coach, what's the message you send at halftime here?
Well, I can tell you what Forrest Gregg told us when we were down 21-0 at the Super Bowl in the first half, and he said, boys, you can't screw it up any worse than you already have. Just go out there and give them a shot. And we got pretty close in the second half, so I don't know if you can overcome this kind of deficit against this team, though.
Fourth and 10, and of course, there's no field goal in a situation like this. You don't even think about it. You go for it, and that's what happens when you go for it. Morgan Burnett on a safety blitz.
Comes Morgan Burnett up, and a big return for them. There's once again Matt Forte not getting anything done with the pass protection. But Morgan Burnett is one of those guys, and it's probably the hardest thing to understand about football, is that you have a quarterback on the back end. And against New Orleans, Burnett was out and there were a lot of mistakes made just getting checks. They were slow to get there, and a guy like Morgan Burnett, who understands this defense so well, can just make all the pieces fit, and all of a sudden, Clinton Dix looks better. Micah Hyde has an interception. This defense looks much better than what they did 2 weeks ago.
Starks taken down at the 40 by Shea McClellan. Knocked Rogers out with a busted collarbone for half the season last year at about this time. 2 minute warning. You've been warned. 35-0 Green Bay. At halftime, Matthew Stafford leading the Lions to another win. They beat Miami today. Peter King will check in with an injury update on Carson Palmer, who got hurt toward the end of the Arizona win today. Bob Costas weighing in on Lambeau Field. 58 seasons, your home to Green Bay.
319!
Tonight. Very happy night for the full house, the normal full house here. Rodgers already has 5 touchdown passes. And you got a flag here because Jordy Nelson was adjusting and Tim Jennings ran into him.
Aaron Rodgers, even when he's got a layup, still takes the time to look the safety off to make sure he's just one-on-one on the outside. And this has been a nightmarish night so far for this defense.
Pass interference, defense, number 23. The ball replaced at the spot of the foul, automatic first down.
I think he meant Jennings.
Yeah, Tim Jennings.
Fuller, yeah, Jennings, 26.
And Jordy Nelson, maybe not the fastest guy in the league, but is coming up with more big plays than anybody, and all you have to do is receive it. But he doesn't want just the pass interference. He wanted that ball. He's fighting back for it. And Aaron Rodgers just no issues throwing it as far as he wants to.
It's a 53-yard penalty.
18.
At the 7, first and goal. Caught, and this is Cobb, and then he loses the ball, and it is picked up in the end zone. He lost the ball, and then it is down in the end zone. And you got a fight breaking out as well. And Ryan Mundy was the guy who came up with the ball in the end zone. So was it a fumble is the question. Now you got a skirmish at the end of the play.
It's going to be interesting now because he was sort of rolling over on the back of the defender. Watch. Now it's going to, he's going to be on. Not down, not down, not down. I think that ball may be out. Ordinarily, you know, just say, all right, the ground's going to cause a fumble, but did he ever get to the ground? And then Lance Briggs came over, and maybe his knee knocks it out.
Well, it would be...
The ruling on the field is a fumble recovered in the end zone by Chicago for a touchback. We also have a dead ball, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, Chicago number 23. That penalty is half the distance to goal. Chicago will have the ball first and 10 at the 10-yard line.
Well, it's also, it's a turnover, which means it gets reviewed automatically. And they're looking at that in New York. Kyle Fuller with the personal foul. So they're taking a look at this to begin with. All turnovers, all scoring plays, as you know, reviewed.
Still moving forward, and the ball is out before I think anything. It would take probably his elbow or backside to hit first, and I don't think either did before Briggs knocked it out with his knee. So good effort by Cobb trying to get some extra yardage, but this time it goes against him.
Agreed, and here comes the personal foul.
Number 70 has reported, number 72.
And as ruled on the field, it will stand. So Chicago gets the turnover. And they have it at the 10-yard line. Quick throw to the outside. Two-top catch. Marshall fighting his way. And picks up the first down, gain of 13.
Well, interesting. One official stopped the clock, and the other one kept it rolling.
And the one who stopped the clock wins the battle here. He's a stop with 132.
One thing we know for sure is Clay Matthews has no problem getting sideline to sideline. We have some of those next generation stats. I'd like to see how many miles he ran that first half.
And Forte is the intended receiver. And Green Bay is going to take a timeout before a second and 10. Sunday Night Football being brought to you by Verizon XLTE on America's largest, most reliable 4G LTE network. By Sears, performance starts here. By Miller Lite, back in its original look, it's Miller time. And by the first ever 306 horsepower RC Coupe from Lexus. Touchdown exhibit here at the Neville Museum in Green Bay, Wisconsin.
I saw a sign out there around one of those leather helmets. It said something like, when a face mask used to be a face. And that's about right. No such thing. Of course, now they kind of use them as weapons, and there's a pretty good weapon right there.
Ball at the 24-yard line, Cutler. And that'll be caught up at the 37-yard line. Alshon Jeffrey hustling the line of scrimmage. Chicago trying to do something, anything. They have one timeout.
Well, plenty of time, and we've seen it so many times in the past. If you can do something to get on the board before half, who knows?
Oh, look out. Cutler sack, fumble, strip, recovered by Peppers. So the two guys have been teammates the last few years, and that's your hat trick. Sack, forced fumble, recovery.
Well, there's Michael Ola, who was moved from guard to tackle, and you can see Jay Cutler just had absolutely no idea that his former teammate was coming to get him. Sack number 5 for Julius Peppers, and every time you get a little hint of maybe the Bears will get something going, it goes the other way again.
Well, you look at Peppers, and one real disparity between the way these teams have been built. Green Bay very rarely goes into the free agent market. Ted Thompson, he likes them homegrown through the draft. Get them as original Packers. There are only five guys on the entire Green Bay team that ever played for another team. Only five. By far the fewest in the league. Chicago has 31 guys that have played with other teams. Rodgers, little dump off, is incomplete. So it'll be second down and 10. There it is. Chicago, 31 guys on the roster who previously played for another team. That's the most in the league. And Green Bay, by far the fewest. I think the second fewest has 15. And there is Ted Thompson, and that's how he's built this team. And they've had tremendous success. They've been to the playoffs 5 consecutive years, and Chicago's been to the playoffs once in 7 years. Second and 10. Lacy.
And I tell you, one of the interesting parts about that is that Mike McCarthy really does not get that involved with the personnel decisions. He says, I don't know how people do that, because I can coach. That's all I have time to do. Let him make those decisions. Works out pretty well.
Timeout pack. 35 points. Most in the first half of any game in a Green Bay-Chicago game for the Packers. Mark Trestman, who went into the locker room in Foxborough 2 weeks ago with a huge deficit, will revisit that scenario tonight. As Green Bay had taken the timeout, third down and 6. Rodgers fires, caught, 18-yard line. That's Jordy Nelson. They're out of timeout, so Rodgers will get off to the line of scrimmage. Jordy Nelson, 6 catches for 152 yards. Rodgers is 3 yards shy of 300. And he gets out of the pocket and just throws it away with 23 seconds, second down.
The only thing at this point that could ruin this night for the Green Bay Packers is one of those scrambles that we saw in New Orleans, and Aaron Rodgers grabbed that hamstring one more time. I've got to tell you, every time now I look at it, I'm like, hey, what are you doing? Just throw it away. This thing's in the books here. But he can't help himself. He's that kind of athlete. And Jay Cutler, and what do you do? You know?
Yeah, what do you do?
I don't know. I ain't got nothing for the Bears.
Middle, up on it.
Second and 10. 19.
Don't play the Packers.
Rodgers, will he get a 6-touchdown pass? Not here. Far less the intended receiver. Third and 10.
I can't tell you, though, how impressed I am with T.J. Lang and Josh Sitton inside. For them to come back from their ankle and toe injury, they've got some made-up toe, you know, made-up shoe to try and accommodate them. Here's Sitton inside. There's T.J. Lang. Those guys have kept Aaron Rodgers pretty clean here tonight.
Blitz. And what a catch. Randall Cobb with Hurst trying to get the ball away from him. But into the end zone, Randall Cobb, who almost got there a couple of minutes ago. They'll take another look, obviously, with a scoring play. If it stands, it'll be 6 touchdowns in the first half.
That's
fabulous. That's unbelievable.
That's just sick. Does it stay? Yep. That's a touchdown.
Yep.
That possession. And anything that happens after that, that doesn't matter.
Never hit the ground.
10 touchdowns now on the year for Randall Cobb. I believe in the last 2 games, he's had 2 each against the Chicago Bears. And this is the toughest coverage there is for anybody. Just a go route from an inside position with all that field to work. What a throw, but what a catch. Not a bad time for Randall Cobb to be a free agent.
Extra point is good. Well, we saw Roethlisberger throw 6 in 60 minutes. We've seen Rodgers throw 6 in 30 minutes. Crosby kicking off. He's had a lot of experience doing that tonight. Now Chris Williams coming up the middle. Flag is thrown. Tackled at the 43. Here's at the moment, 7 seconds left on the clock.
During the return, holding. Return team, number 36. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Green Bay has had the ball for 7 possessions in the first half. 6 touchdowns, and then the Cobb fumble into the end zone.
Those 3 are pretty dynamic, aren't they? I mean, they are starting to set a standard. We were talking to Jordy Nelson about it a little bit. He said Aaron Rodgers, forget the playbook. The playbook doesn't count. The playbook is the start, and then he expects exact reactions on every play. And Jordy Nelson and Randall Cobb are getting it done.
Chicago just wants to go back to the locker room. Aaron Rodgers. How's that hamstring doing? 42-0. Coming up next, Toyota halftime after these messages from your NBC station. And back at Lambeau Field, all the buzz belonging to Green Bay. They lead 42-0. Tied for the second largest halftime lead in NFL history. Largest was 45-0 New England over Tennessee in 09. Darryl LaMonica, the only other guy to throw 6 touchdown passes in any half. That was John Madden's 6th game as a coach. He wound up with 6 that day. Nelson and Cobb, their numbers. All Green Bay all the time. The Bears 42 points allowed most in any half in the history of that fabled franchise. Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Michelle DeFoya. We'll be joined by Bob Uecker in the show. Well, I wish he would. The great Milwaukee Brewer announcer.
In fact, they could play a baseball game if they wanted to.
Yeah.
Call anything.
From the 3-yard line, DeJuan Harris will bring the ball back to the 24, and I'm interested to see what Michelle has for us. Michelle.
Well, trailing 42-0 at halftime, a fairly resigned Mark Trestman told me, we played a half of terrible football in all 3 phases of the game. He told me he would tell his team at halftime, we're not a good team right now. We have a good team in there. We have to go find it. As for Mike McCarthy, he said that they want to come out and punch them in the mouth. They'll watch these first couple of series and then discuss just how long they want to leave Aaron Rodgers in there.
Well, punch him in the mouth. That's exactly what they did in the first half. They knocked them out.
Yeah, don't use the word resigned.
Yeah. Referee stops contest. And they begin with a loss on the ground. Eddie Lacy taken down a couple of yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, you're going to find a lot about this football team, the Chicago Bears. And, you know, Jay Cutler, you know he's a competitive guy. You know Mark Trestman's a competitive guy, and they want to win. But, you know, one of the things that I think frustrates people sometimes is that they keep their cool so well and stay focused that you want to see a little emotion sometimes. And especially getting a situation like this, there just doesn't really matter if you show emotion or not.
Second and 13 from the 20-yard line. Rodgers, 315 yards in the air in the opening half.
Well, in the National Football League, people have different definitions. This would be the definition of open for Jordy Nelson on two plays. Ordinarily in the NFL, if you're open by a yard, by a half a yard, that is considered quite a margin. In this game, that's a joke. And then Jordy Nelson on the tail end of the Eddie Lacy touchdown with the block going down the field. And he was telling us that Edgar Bennett, the running back coach, forces them to block. And if the defender gets a finger on the running back, they get a negative grade.
Rodgers throws, and that is dropped. So Cobb was open, going to the ground. Rodgers barking at himself, fourth down.
And Tim Maste coming out for a rare appearance here.
Yeah.
Right? It's been now six quarters, and this is the first punt this year against the Bears.
That first meeting between these teams, week four, a puntless game. 17 drives against the Bears. First time he had to bring out the punter. Santonio Holmes is back. Here's a flag down. And he got contact at the 40-yard line. And Holmes picks it up. And another flag comes down. So you have a flag that was thrown at the inception of the play. And then one as the ball was coming to Holmes. Two separate fouls. And the call to be made here by first-year referee Craig Rolstad.
Teddy Williams down the field kind of took a shot at Devon House, lunged into his face mask, and the flag immediately came in that area. Here you'll get a look at it. You see House, he's looking for the ball, and then bang. Launching, crown of the helmet, probably whatever you want to call it. Frustration is really what it is.
During the return, personal foul. Chicago, number 24. The 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. Chicago keeps the ball, first down.
Okay. They must have picked up the other one. McCarthy said, what about the other flag?
This is Sunday night.
That may have been Mark Trestman's halftime speech, but no, that was Clay Matthews. And how's the experiment going with him? The next generation stats tell us that he has already run 612 yards, and I believe it. This experiment is an overwhelming success. Clay Matthews has simply added an energy level to this defense and an ability to stop the run that heretofore really didn't exist. He is chasing plays sideline to sideline. Then when they put him back outside, he just makes Jamon Bushrod look silly on that play. You want to run a reverse? You won't run it again.
He's run three eighths of a mile. He had a phenomenal first half. Cutler has to pack it in. And let's go to Michelle.
Well, I grabbed Clay Matthews as he was coming out onto the field for pregame warmups. Asked him about the move to inside linebacker. He said it's definitely different. Someone's got to do it. And he realized it was his turn. I asked if he called his father, Clay, to talk about it. He said yes. But when I asked what advice his dad gave him, he simply smiled and said, let's talk after the game. But Mike McCarthy told me at halftime, we're getting out of the move just what we thought we would.
Oh, yeah. And his dad, of course, was a great player. His grandfather played. His uncle Bruce was a great guard. Pretty good DNA there.
And I talked to Dom Capers, the defensive coordinator, and I said, well, how did Clay feel about this? And he said, you know, he's a team guy. He'll do whatever. But when you're asking an all-pro guy who's going to get penciled into the Pro Bowl every year to change his position and his status in this league by going to a new position, but he said, I knew he would do it and buy into it, but I don't think even Papa could have imagined that his son would buy into playing middle linebacker the way that he has so far in this game.
Your dad, most of his career, 16 seasons with the Cleveland Browns, and then leaving Atlanta, he got a whistle before the snap.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, number 74, 5-yard penalty, replay, third down.
Yeah, you block Clay Matthews, you got to get off and a little sooner than otherwise. But I tell you, you see the motion on the outside. But Clay Matthews' father in Cleveland, I played against a lot, was one of the most intuitive players that I ever played against. And you can see that his son gets it equally well and runs a little faster.
Totally. To the 19-yard line goes Matt Forte.
I just love it, though, when a guy is willing to do something like that for his team. You know, it's not in his best interest to do this. I saw Andrew Whitworth, the tackle of the Cincinnati Bengals, move into guard when he was a Pro Bowler year after year. But he did what was right for the football team. And for Clay Matthews to step up like that, it screams to the rest of the team of what's important for us is much more important than what's important for me.
Certainly. Well, there's a blocked punt. So it continues as Jared Boykin is able to block it. And then O'Donnell winds up covering it. That doesn't matter because they'll lose it on downs. And Green Bay will be knocking on the door again.
There he is. Little inside move. Right there. And just a slip down on the outside. This thing is just kicked it with his foot.
Yeah, look at that. I've never seen that.
Kicked it before the punter kicked it. You always think after you've done this for 400 years that I've done this, there's always something.
Every 400 years, there's something new.
Earlier this year, we saw Antonio Brown stiff arm with his foot.
Mm-hmm. Now that's got to be a first. The guy who blocks it kicks it before the punter can get his foot on it. Meanwhile, you got a first and goal. The play clock at one. And Rodgers able to get it off and then dumps it, and it's almost intercepted. Willie Young was there. Pressure put on by Stephen Paya, and it'll make it second down and goal.
Right here, Stephen Paya working against the right guard, really, T.J. Lang, but he was trying to get out on the screen. And then Willie Young, he's a guy that's got arms and legs going everywhere. At least they're still fighting. They're not giving it up.
Can Rodgers get into the record book with the others? 7 touchdowns in a game is the record. Here's Lacy. He'll fight his way. Look at him taking everybody with him down to the 1.5. 7 touchdowns in the game is the record. Joe Capp did it in 69, and then it wasn't done again until Peyton Manning did it on an opening night against Baltimore last year on a Sunday night, and Nick Foles of Philadelphia did it in Oakland in the middle of the season.
You know, the interesting thing is a lot of times the coaches don't know there are records out there. Remember, we were talking to Ben Roethlisberger, and he had the 522 and had a chance to break the NFL record, and the coordinators and head coach, they all said they didn't have a clue. They just didn't know.
3rd and goal. Again, the play clock all the way down, and Rodgers has to take a timeout. So the storyline after New Orleans was Rodgers tweaking the hamstring, going out of bounds, played the rest of the game, did not look like Aaron Rodgers, went away, put him on a program. He answered every question tonight.
Yeah, he did it all in therapy. But it was the first time that I think I had ever really seen Aaron not throw as accurately. It was almost like his mind was telling him to do one thing and his body was reacting a little bit differently. And it wasn't missing by miles, but it usually you just see him, you know, it's right in the chest or right in the hands. And on that night, he was just off, and you could tell that it really impacted him. And to see him come all the way back and play like this, and I'm a little surprised to see him here in the second half. I don't know if you are or not, but I thought they might just sit him down.
Well,
here.
Not much longer. Remember, McCarthy, though, said we want to punch him in the mouth. Now a timeout is taken by Chicago.
Timeout, Chicago. This is our first.
Before third and goal. So, Rodgers, the six halves or the six quarters plus a few minutes here in the second half. And what he's done, 10 touchdowns, no interceptions against the Bears. That's his career. Touchdowns per start, 2.17. And then you got Manning and Breeze next. So that's the most in the history of the National Football League per start.
This guy's ability to retain knowledge. I mean, he understands. He was recounting games against the Bears from 2010, 2009. You know, he has the ability to take the knowledge like a Peyton Manning or Drew Brees or Tom Brady and apply it on the football field during the game, and it's really paid off here.
It's a third and goal. Can he get his seventh touchdown pass? No. Intended for Nelson. Fourth down. Crowd wants them to go for it. The crowd, most of them probably know, you know, just by word of mouth or listening to the radio, whatever they're doing. They're good football fans. They probably know the record seven, so they want to see them go for it. But that would really be, you know, that would be pouring it on. I mean, it's not like a field goal is, you know, you're adding three more, but I think if you went for it on fourth down, that's it.
Might be rubbing it in.
Yeah, that's rubbing it. So they settle for the three. The kick is good by Crosby. 10:48 remaining in the third. It's 45-0. Well, you've got Lombardi Avenue. A lot of other things named for the fabled one. Empty on game night. Everybody, it was at Lambeau Field. So. No signal alerts, no traffic.
Definitely a bucket list thing to do, to come to this stadium and watch a ball game at some point in your life.
A yard deep, Chris Williams. He's run back about 500 kicks tonight. And let's go to Michelle.
Well, Al, if you take a look here, the clock on your left is set to the correct local time. On the right is the clock outside the stadium facing Lombardi Avenue. It's 15 minutes fast in honor of Vince Lombardi, because to Lombardi, on time meant exactly 15 minutes early to everything. And former Packers Jerry Kramer and Willie Davis confirmed that fact to team president Mark Murphy, who decided to set the stadium's clock accordingly.
And Michelle, as you well know, and Chris does too, on our crew, it's known as Goodelli time. Producer Fred goes by the same clock. To the 28-yard line, a catch is made, and to the 32 goes Matt Forte. Tackled there by A.J. Hawk.
Yeah, but Bob Costas has broken his spirit.
Yes. Bob's still on daylight savings time.
Tom Coughlin looks soft compared to Vince Lombardi. Huh? He used to be 5 minutes ahead, and made Michael Strahan crazy.
Yeah, we love sitting down with Coughlin. I always look at his clock and go, wait, what time is it? It's always 5 minutes ahead. And Forte takes it up to the 37-yard line.
Well, for the Chicago Bears, it doesn't seem like this is an important half, but it really is, because people in Chicago are watching right now, and there will be decisions made. These are the kinds of games where people's jobs start becoming in jeopardy. And for Jay Cutler, the Chicago Bears, if they like the people around them, they had better put on a little bit of a show here this second half.
And Cutler, he gets taken down. And again, it's Clay Matthews who got him up high, and thus you have a flag. Clay's going to say he was ducking down, and where do you want me to go?
Personal foul. Blow to the head. defense, number 52. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Coming around the edge right here. No question about the call. Relatively easy. And it finally dawned on me, he looks a little like Troy Polamalu here tonight. He just looks like he is able to unleash all that energy that he has. He's flying from all different directions the same way that Troy would.
The officials are deciding where to re-spot the ball. All right, and watch it off.
I'll tell you a couple other guys that have helped tonight as well. We haven't talked about Dayton Jones back, number one draft pick a season ago, and Sam Shields back at the cornerback position. Now, this is a team that is starting to get some depth as well. Devon House had to play corner for a while with Shields out. We've seen Josh Boyd. We've seen a lot of different guys here have to step up and fill in. This team's starting to develop a little depth now.
Pressure again, a little floater caught by Forte, and he's run out of bounds by Perry.
Talked a little bit about those corners and how they've played. Tremont Williams on the other side, and these were the big two. You know, Brandon Marshall, Alshon Jeffrey, they had been hurt earlier in the year. They are healthy now. The feeling was that maybe the big plays would return for this offense, and they just haven't.
Second and five. Stuffed in the backfield. For those of you scoring at home, Matthews does not get a sack. Personal foul negated the play, so that was a no-play penalty. And also, scoring at home, that wasn't a punt on the block punt. It was a fumble because the punter never was able to put his foot to the ball.
If you're scoring at home, that means you're watching at home, and we'd like to thank you.
Yes, we love you. We hope you have a Nielsen book. Third and seven from the 46. And Cutler, and in adjusting, Marshall makes the catch, and he's going to get to the goal line and in. Touchdown. The Marshall comes back, he adjusts, he breaks a tackle, and then is able to dive into the end zone.
The Green Bay Packers send everybody. There's no free safety in the middle of the field. Marshall finds the ball first and then just fights his way into the end zone. That's the kind of effort you want to see if you're part of the ownership of the Chicago Bears. Are they going to quit? Or are they going to keep playing? Nice play by Brandon Marshall.
45 yards to get off the schneid.
Now that forearm went down, but I think the ball was across the line at that point.
The Packers had scored 66 unanswered points before Chicago was able to get on the board here. Chicago actually had the lead late in the first half in that game against Green Bay at Soldier Field in September. Robbie Gould for the point after. So about halfway through the third quarter, Bears break the ice. Still a very icy night in Chicago, 45-7. All right, the Tonight Show all this week on NBC. Jimmy Fallon among those he'll welcome. Channing Tatum will be there. NBC State of Affairs, Katherine Heigl. All on the Tonight Show with the good and great Jimmy Fallon on NBC. Green Bay will begin its next drive from the 20. We might be seeing Matt Flynn at quarterback. Aaron Rodgers may be done for the night. All he did was throw six touchdowns. Sunday Night Football being brought to you by DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you got to get DirecTV. Buy the all-new Kia Sedona by Bud Light. Stay in the game and drink responsibly. And by Walmart, where you'll find unbeatable prices on this year's top gifts. That is the A Road to Berlin exhibit opening at the World War II Museum in New Orleans on December 13th. A fabulous place to visit down in the Bayou.
It is indeed. Tom Hanks, Steven Spielberg have a great film in there. Pretty awesome.
So you've got Flynn in the game. Lacy picks up five. So how did Aaron Rodgers do tonight? After all that talk about the hamstring in New Orleans, 67%, 315, six touchdowns.
He was the NFC Offensive Player of the Week when he played the Bears last time, and I'd say he's got a shot this time,
pretty
too.
Pretty good. Pretty good chance.
What do you think Lance Briggs is thinking right now? What are you thinking, where's Brian Urlacher?
Briggs is pretty open about the fact that he thinks this is the last time he'll be in Lambeau Field as a Bear. And there's Lacy. And he's probably right about that. Lance Briggs, been a longtime linebacker in Chicago. He's the kind of guy that would be strongly considered for the Hall of Fame. He's been that good and was telling us the other day that, like to probably continue to play if the opportunity arises.
I really enjoyed talking to Mike McCarthy about Lance Briggs, and he said he is as good a backer as we have seen in this league over the last 10 years. You take all of his work, that's a guy that deserves to be in the Hall of Fame consideration, and he just thought that he had a way of anticipating plays that was really special.
And Flynn slips, gets back up, throws a wobbly duck downfield. You get all kinds of contact. You got a flag coming in. You got Boykin and Fuller involved in the action.
Pass interference. Defense, number 23. The ball in class at the spot of the foul. First down.
On Fuller.
Well, what happens is you get to this point in the game and you have no choice as a defensive coordinator but to try and blitz. And the net result is then you end up with one-on-one situations down the field. And if your blitz doesn't get home, then guys like Kyle Fuller get exposed. I mean, it's the oldest thing in football. Do you want to bring pressure? You want to play coverage. And when you're down by this score, you have to try and bring pressure.
34-yard penalty. Flynn. And off the play fake, Flynn throws, it's caught by Richard Rodgers. But Flynn is such an interesting story in the sense that he was a backup quarterback, and then because they'd already clinched everything 3 years ago, he gets the start against Detroit. He has a phenomenal day, which winds up getting him a big contract in Seattle, and he's going to be the Seahawks starting quarterback. He's got all the money and the whole thing. He goes to Seattle, and then they draft a kid named Russell Wilson. And then Pete Carroll shocks the world by making Wilson the starting quarterback. So Flynn's a backup again, goes to Oakland. That doesn't work out. Here he is backing up Rodgers again.
Not a bad place to be. You only get to play when you're up 45-7.
And it's incomplete. Again intended for Boykin. Third and six. Sitton is done for the night. Playing through probably some at least semblance of pain. Same with TJ Lang, and so you've got Lane Taylor and JC Treader in there at the guard spots.
And for JC Treader, this is his first career game. He's had a lot of injuries in the first 2 years, and a lot of people thought he would end up being the center, but what good news for the Packers to get Rodgers, Lang, and Sitton out of the game. Another week to rest.
36, low throw intended for Brandon Bostic, who scored the first touchdown tonight.
Let's take a look. There's Treader right there. And Stephen Paez, give him a little inside move. We'll give you guys a scouting report. Let you watch some of these new guys. Those old guys are pretty good there, though. I mean, they really are the cornerstone. And when Corey Linsley, the rookie, was thrown into the mix in Seattle, they sort of coached his way through that tough stadium.
52-yard attempt for Crosby, and it is good. You don't see a lot of 52-yarders at night. in Lambeau Field. The Green Bay doing everything tonight. 48-7. Well, we sure hope this guy has another year in him. Really good guy. Charles Peanut Tillman. We did that game in San Francisco. Week two, torn triceps, out for the season. Traveling with the team and still trying to aid the defensive backs as best he can. Hopefully the return is in store for him. 5 yards in, Chris Williams. All his run backs tonight have been pretty much of similar length in the history of these teams. Curly Lambeau, playing career, 9 years with the Packers, and George Halas, 10 years, and then Lambeau with 29 seasons, won 6 championships. Halas, of course, owned the team. 40 seasons as a head coach. Head-to-head, Halas by a 2-1 margin. Both inducted charter members of the Hall of Fame. And for, there's the designation for Lambeau. I mean, Halas, 40 years, and he had him in 4 10-year increments. Every 10 years, he would step down for a while, and then he'd come back. Cutler. He's taken off the shoe tops by Brandon Marshall for a short game.
Hey, one of the guys for the Packers, I think, played a pretty darn good game tonight. It's this guy, Micah Hyde. Of course, had the interception earlier on. But he is sort of this hybrid safety corner, which really makes him a nice fit for covering tight ends that have become in vogue in this league. So every time the offense has come up with a little something new, you have to find people that can answer that. And Micah Hyde seems to fit that role pretty darn well.
McCarthy, does he want to challenge that play?
Green Bay is challenging the ruling on the field of a completed pass.
All right. A three-yard completion. And does the ball touch the ground?
I don't think so.
Not from that angle, anyway. It's a good catch, I think.
Yeah, I thought it was, too.
That was a 1st and 10. 2nd and 7, so. Well, you know, when you're a coach and it's 48-7 and it really doesn't mean a heck of a lot. And then he's thinking to himself, why did I do that?
Here's what I think
happened. He now knows.
I think he thought that was for a first down. I think he may have gotten the wrong chain marker and thought he was giving up a first down on that one.
Yeah, I think you may be right because, I mean, you know, you get a challenge, a 3-yard gain and 48-7 gain. And
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. and for Mark Trestman, well, the only good news is when you make a trip home after a night game, at least it's only about a 40-minute flight.
The call on the field stands as called. Green Bay is charged with a timeout.
Boy, that might come back to bite him, huh?
Anytime you see them talking out of the side of their mouth to the referee, they're going, oh, man, I kind of messed that up.
What did I do that for, yeah?
It was really interesting talking with Mike about the evolution of the first 15 plays. You know that whole thing, Bill Walsh, we did it in Cincinnati, and the whole deal of how you plan those things out, and then you tell the players about it.
Marshall will get the first down. Few more yards.
And he said, I had to quit doing it when he first got here because certain players would have anxiety if they knew what the first 15 plays were, and plays would come, you know, there's a long pass or something, and the guys couldn't sleep at night because they knew it. So I ended up having to just not tell them, and so now it's the first 7. So they practice the first 7 plays now. He said it's a long way from the days when I used to go to Kinko's and get those layovers and we'd draw all over it, and that was my job to start this league.
And a flag here is Forte gets taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Holding offense, number 75, 10-yard penalty, replay, first down.
So among other things for Chicago tonight, that's 11 penalties against them. Penalty is on Chris Long here. Kyle Long.
Just one of those other billionaires in that family.
A lot of Longs.
Pick any of them. It doesn't make any difference.
Make it 10 penalties for 158.
Kyle, a Pro Bowler a season ago, and probably their best this year. Everybody else in and out of the lineup. He's the only guy that's played in every game so far on that offensive line, I should say.
We'll get Howie Long into the game before this one's over. Second and 11.
Not with a forklift.
And Cutler able to step up, get away, get the pass off. Only for minor gain, Dante Rosario, and there's Clay Matthews in the action again.
Well, here's the only thing you lose with Clay Matthews playing linebacker is now he's got to drop into coverage, right? So you think, oh, you're losing something on the pass rush. But look at the reaction time. I mean, this guy is exploding all over the field. And if anything, I think tonight, Al, we're seeing he's even better in space than when he's just limited to one side of the ball.
And you said it before. I mean, the unselfishness of a guy being asked to go inside. I mean, outside linebackers a lot more glamorous than inside linebackers. Kind of their on-the-run throws and the passes incomplete. You're playing on the outside, you're going to get the sacks. You play in space. Keith Jackson says you can pin your ears back. Different on the inside.
Yeah, and plus now he's rushing against guards instead of tackles. That time he got buried on the play by Roberto Garza. But here's my guy Micah Hyde on the back end covering Martellus Bennett and getting it done once again. That's a tough assignment on a big guy. I stood next to Martellus Bennett at the Bears facility. He is a big guy. Michael Hyde so far tonight all over.
There's O'Donnell. He fumbled the last snap. That's a bad punt here. And let's go back to Aaron Rodgers tonight. And the first of his six right there. Bostic got him started. Rolling right, extending the play. Number two, Jordy Nelson. Free, ran back toward the middle. Again, Rodgers, as he does so brilliantly. Nelson again, making the catch in the end zone. And then Eddie Lacy with a spectacular screen. Early blocking there. Late blocking to get him into the end zone. And Cobb with a phenomenal catch. And there's your dirty half dozen.
Back-to-back weeks for us seeing six touchdown passes, right? Right, Big Ben?
Last week.
319!
And then the Jets go out and beat Pittsburgh today. Tell me anybody knows anything. Starks to the 42-yard line. Rodgers at Lambeau Field in the regular season. Off the charts. 112 TD passes and 22 interceptions. Better than 5-1. 32-3. In his last, we gave him the win tonight. Aren't we generous? And against division opponents, about almost 90%. Starks again. To the 45, with 2:20 to go in the third.
I'll tell you, there's some young quarterbacks in the game that I think get it now. Andrew Luck, Russell Wilson come to mind first and foremost for me. But for me, playing quarterback in the NFL is about manipulating data. You know, understanding what they're trying to do to you, do it at a pace that puts pressure on the defense, and then once you drop back, be able to understand all the things that you've been trained to do, all the experiences you've had against those styles of defenses, and be able to pick apart. And Aaron Rodgers right now, with his youth, his arm, his athleticism, and his intelligence, I think absolutely at the top of the game.
Well, he's the full package. And we talked about it in New Orleans, having that discussion about if you had one guy you could pick right now, taking everything into consideration. Of course, you don't pick maybe Brady or Peyton Manning because of their ages. I mean, they're toward the end of their career. This guy's right in the middle.
Yeah,
Drew Brees is later on in his career, too. I mean, he's the guy right here.
Maybe. It would
well,
be
Luck,
a tough...
Andrew Luck. Well,
that
yeah,
that
right.
would be the tough choice right there.
Right.
I think Rodgers is more advanced at this point. But when you start extrapolating out, wouldn't you like to have a little Andrew Luck for about the next 15, 16 years?
Speaking of Andrew Luck, as a fair catch is made here by Chris Williams, we will see. Number 12 in action against the other 12. It'll be New England against Indianapolis. Pats Colts, Thanksgiving night, meanwhile. Don't forget, we've got the Seahawks and the 49ers for your dessert that night from Santa Clara. Brady Luck next week. Their numbers this season, time with 22 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. Yeah, we were in New England, and the sky was falling after that Kansas City Monday night debacle. And all they've done is won 5 in a row since.
I'll tell you, Colin Kaepernick made a big play on fourth down today, didn't he?
Oh,
holy
yeah.
Cow, that one looked like it was going to go against him. And Kaepernick scrambled right, threw it all the way back across the field to Crabtree. What a play that was.
The field goal tied it, sent it to overtime, and the 49ers won the game. Brandon Marshall. As we say, you know, Pittsburgh, I mean, Pittsburgh, we see them last week, and then they lose to the Jets. And meanwhile, Tampa Bay's only win this season is against Pittsburgh, in Pittsburgh. As I said many times, nobody knows anything.
No, that's for sure. But one thing you do know is...
Especially us.
That New York Jets defense, not too bad. They got some men playing along that front line.
Second and one. Forte to the 29-yard line. For a first down. So Green Bay rolling off to a hot start tonight. Chicago could do next to nothing right on either side of the ball. Jordy Nelson with a huge night, 152, and a pair of touchdowns. And Green Bay will get ready to host Philadelphia here next week as we will go to the fourth quarter. End of three, 48-7 Green Bay. Sunday Night Football resumes after these messages. High above Lambeau Field, tonight's aerial coverage is brought to you by Geico. Al Michaels, Chris Collinsworth, Michelle Tafoya, Fred Godelli, Drew Esikoff, down in the truck with our gang, bringing you Sunday Night Football. Tonight's attendance, another sellout, over 78,000 at Lambeau Field, which has been expanded over the years. Nice job there, too. Cutler. Deep downfield and almost intercepted. Getting position on it was the cornerback Devon House. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver, second down.
Tried to go a little out and up route against Devon House, and this is the point, if you're watching the film, they say, well, how did he drop that? Well, if he could have caught that, he would have played wide receiver. But that's what... You know, it's whatever it is. Sometimes defensive backs, you always go back and count, and they all talk about, I could have had 15 interceptions this year. Yeah.
7-10. Whoops. Whoop. Falling down that time as Jeffrey was able to get by House and pick up the first down. And there's a... It's part of the expansion over the last 10 or 15 years at Lambeau, adding extra seats, especially in the end zone, the big replay boards. What do you call them these days? We used to call them Jumbotrons, but then a lot of companies got involved. And
I got chewed out once for calling them Jumbotron.
Too.
I'm afraid to call it TV. I'm just going to call it TV.
And Cutler throwing it deep downfield again, and that's incomplete. And a flag is down back at the 30-yard line, normally in the illegal contact area.
Prior to the pass, holding defense number 31. It's a 5-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Or in the defensive holding area. Mark Murphy has done a tremendous job with this team, heading the whole operation, president, CEO, former player with Washington and with Ted Thompson. They have put this franchise into the very upper echelon of NFL franchises, 5 straight years to the playoffs, and right now on a pace where, you know, to keep it up, they're behind Detroit, but this would make them 6-3, so they are very much obviously in the hunt for postseason. Speaking of the NFC North, so the Lions win. They beat Miami 20-16, and Jim Caldwell very quietly has done a pretty terrific job in the Motor City. They are 7-2. The Packers will go to 6-3 after this game. Minnesota's 4-5. Minnesota goes to Chicago to meet the Bears next week in Soldier Field. Bears will drop to 3-6.
Calvin Johnson came back and looked good today. Of course, Golden Tate's been tremendous while he's been out.
And Cutler to Marshall, taken down by Richardson. Well, Brandon, that's not what you need in a 48-7 game. Have your top receiver get up and hobble off.
It has been that kind of year for Brandon Marshall. Started with injuries, came back, really had to battle through it against San Francisco, and was just so brilliant in that game, and finally gotten healthy, and here we go again.
Yep. Injury timeout. Well, that promo featured Brandon Marshall putting the jacket on Chris. Sunday Sports Report following. We just saw Marshall go off the field. Check on him in a second here. First and 10 at the 34-yard line for the Bears as Cutler retreats, throws, and that'll be a 12-yard gain and a first down into the hands of Santonio Holmes.
Looks like the left ankle here for Brandon Marshall, and I think it was the right ankle, right, that he hurt earlier in the year. So one of those kind of seasons as he tries to limp it off. Really, he's played a good game here tonight.
Forte to the 19-yard line. For Jay Cutler, just another very fruitless trip to Lambeau Field, where his lifetime mark will go to 0-4. It's one of those nights where, you know, the numbers look pretty good, but, you know, a lot of times the numbers look good and they don't mean a thing. Rogers' numbers are pretty good tonight, too, but they do mean a thing.
But not all those numbers. Numbers down here don't look so good.
No. The 3-6 doesn't look very good either. Second and 6. And Forte for a short game.
You know what's interesting is that Jay Cutler, really, when he played in Denver, did not get sacked that often. You know, they played in that Shanahan system, and it was the stretch plays and some bootlegs off of it, and taking advantage of his mobility. And you've seen it some tonight. You know, he dances around the pocket. He's got a little Aaron Rodgers in him. He obviously has a strong arm. This offensive line is filled with, you know, good players. I just don't get it. I can't even explain it. This much talent and just nothing to show for it here lately.
Very enigmatic to his career.
Boy.
And that's intercepted by Casey Hayward. And Hayward is out in front, and Casey Hayward able to stay in bounds, and a few more for the Green Bay Packers. 82 yards.
A screen pass. I mean, this is what we've got going tonight. They're just sneaking through on a little screen pass underneath. It gets tipped off of somebody or something, and there you go the other way. He hits his own guy, Kyle Long's helmet, and it leads to a pick six. You know, you'd say it's laughable, but in Chicago, this won't be laughable. I mean, this is a city treasure, this franchise, and what they've been able to build there, and their reputation for greatness and toughness and all those things. And this will not sit well.
No. And it comes on top of a blowout in New England. Comes on top of them giving up 50 or more points against Philadelphia on a Sunday night. in the next to last game last year. 55-7. Okay. Sunday Night Football brought to you by Wendy's. Barbecue pulled pork served three tasty ways. By Nationwide. Nationwide is on your side. By T-Mobile and by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Might have got that out. I fumbled the billboard copy. Earlier tonight, 18 members of the Wisconsin National Guard 32nd Combat Brigade visited the Sunday Night Football bus outside Lambeau Field. And Melissa Horton was able to recover it for me. Thank you. As Chris Williams, and this is his by far best run back of the night. Every other one would wind up at about the 20-yard line. And Chris Williams will go all the way in for a touchdown, 101 yards. He's run back so many kicks tonight, sooner or later.
You know, shades of Devin Hester. Here we go. I will say this about Chris Williams. He's not a very big guy, but every kick he's brought out tonight, and even that reverse he ran, he is going hard. And so far in that one, that was awfully special. Good blocking down the field. These special teams guys, they have to practice more than anybody else. They have to meet more than anybody else. There's Brock Vereen making a nice block down the field.
I'll tell you, there's one amazing thing tonight. That's 10 run backs in the game for Chris Williams. At a time in the NFL when almost every kickoff is a touchback, he's run 10 kicks back tonight.
I mean, from the very beginning. And, of course, the game started. They had a penalty on one of those. But he's trying to prove a point. He's trying to prove that he belongs. And I think he just did.
That ties an NFL record, most kickoff returns in a game, of course. The underside of that, your team has given up a hell of a lot of points. Kick off that much and get that many chances. 55-14. NBCSN Wednesday night. If you're a hockey fan, you know it's rivalry night this week. The Boston Bruins, Toronto Maple Leafs started. Second half of the doubleheader, the Los Angeles Kings and the Anaheim Ducks. I think you would know the Kings won the Stanley Cup last year, Chris.
Man, I sure wish one day they'd deliver that cup to my house.
Right. Well, as soon as Cincinnati gets a franchise, you got a shot at it. Wednesday night rivalry, NHL on NBCSN. And that's Rogers pulling in, fair catching right there. Well,
there you go.
Speaking of the Stanley Cup.
And a little speech to go with it. I love it.
Thank you, Kings. Beauty that's going to be. Well, for Mark Trestman, he's watched his team over the last 11 games give up 50 or more points three times. Philadelphia last year and then New England 2 weeks ago tonight. Prior 759 games, the Bears give up 50 or more three times. And this will be DeJuan Harris, who will be number three on the depth chart at running back to the 22-yard line. So for the Packers, 55 points tonight, tied for the most in a game ever here at Lambeau Field. But it's not a franchise record for home game because when they used to play some games at Milwaukee County Stadium, they actually scored more in a game down there. Team record is 57, so it's a happy night for all the guys in green and a very short night of work, but a hugely productive one for one Aaron Rodgers. 45, blue 45, set. Quarterback and Harris. And Harris works his way out to the 30-yard line with 9.5 to go. Mike McCarthy, ninth year as the Packers head coach, 27 points per game under his watch, second only to Sean Payton. Winning record in division games all 8 seasons. And there's the coach himself, John Madden, 37-13-1 record against division opponents. John with a 745 percentage in his tenure with the Oakland Raiders. One of the coaches looking in his office park tonight.
I would imagine that man loves football.
He's probably saying he's all the way, you know, he'll watch the game to the end.
I think that John Madden would have an unbelievable amount of respect for Mike McCarthy. You know, Sean Payton, people would say, yeah, name the top play caller in the NFL, and his name would come up, and he gets credit. This guy doesn't get a fraction of the credit for what he is, not only as a head coach, but as an offensive mind and creative guy. He and Aaron Rodgers now have come up with a communication ability on the field and a pace that is really becoming very hard to stop.
And Flynn throws, and that's incomplete as Devontae Adams cannot hang on.
They really spent this entire off week trying to figure out which curveball the Chicago Bears were going to throw at them. So not only did they throw a major curveball with Clay Matthews going in at the middle linebacker position, and almost every time the Bears come off a bye week, they hit you with something new. And this was a huge something new that worked over the top. And they were trying to figure out what the Bears were going to throw on the other side. And I think the Bears were trying to get back to basics and just get their guys playing fast, and that didn't work. And for Lance Briggs, I can't imagine.
There's to a wild pitch. Timeout, Green Bay. For a limited time, you can watch a free trial of NFL Films Team Yearbook on your connected TV device, or go to NFL.com/now to learn more. It's never too late.
Never.
Third and six. Flynn. Chase. And he just flips that one away. Fourth down. Talking about McCarthy. And Mike will be 51 tomorrow. He's been a coach for a long time. You go back to Fort Hays State in Kansas back in 87, quarterbacks coach at the University of Pittsburgh, worked with Marty Schottenheimer in Kansas City in the late 90s, came here. He was here for 1 year in 99. He was the quarterbacks coach. He had Favre.
Sorry, he tripped over a cord.
Right. I just watched it. I love him. Then the Saints. 49ers, 1 year as offensive coordinator, and that led to a pretty good 9-year run. Mass days. Short one, fielded at the 29 by Chris Williams. And let's check in with Michelle.
Well, wide receiver Brandon Marshall out, as if things couldn't get worse for the Bears. You saw him get tackled here, and that left ankle is the reason he is out. He came to the bench, spoke with head athletic trainer Chris Hanks. They spatted up that left shoe. He tried to run on it, Al. Ultimately went to the locker room with head orthopedic surgeon Mark Bowen, and Brandon Marshall out for the night.
Out for the night. We'll wonder about him next week when they go home against Minnesota. Meanwhile, Cutler is also out for the night because Jimmy Clausen will finish up. Was it Carolina? Cutler puts the parka on, and Clausen will take us to the finish line. And this is Kadeem Carey, a rookie out of Arizona, who backs up Forte. So taking a look down the road here, the Lions go to Arizona. Arizona now 8-1, but you know, you've got the Carson Palmer situation there. Then they go to New England. So two really tough games back-to-back. Lions at home for three. Chicago, Tampa Bay, Minnesota. Go to Chicago, and then wouldn't figure, week 17, where do they wind up? Here. Packers, Philadelphia, at many. New England then comes in. And of course, their final game against Detroit right here, which could be for a lot of marbles. First down for Carey.
Wouldn't mind being here for that one. That would be kind of an exciting night. That Detroit team's tough, boy. They've got a good front line. I know, you have to get your park out.
No, right, whatever.
But it is a, that is an exciting team. And you just wonder now if offensively they start to get it going with Calvin Johnson and Golden Tate and the way they can, you know, run the football. Reggie's getting back and healthy a little bit again. That team, you said it before, quietly has taken the lead, and it really has sort of been quietly.
Remember the last time Detroit beat Green Bay here? 1991. Clausen throws, and you got a jump ball, and just for a moment it looked like House had come down with it, and then the ball floats free and complete.
Pretty tough to go up over Alshon Jeffrey and make this play. This is a nicely played ball here by Devon House. Went up, got his hands on it, and almost came down with that one. We were talking to Tremont Williams about Alshon Jeffrey, and he said, you know, he's got a good one to learn from in Brandon Marshall, but he is a guy that when the ball is in the air has a way of just going up and making plays, but that time Devon House out-battled him.
Hey, 50, Mike.
Play clock has expired. Delay a game.
Delay a game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
11 penalties against the Bears. 163. Miscues. Take your pick. A ton of them.
Some of them are hard to believe.
This one in particular.
There's one I've never seen. Never seen that one. Yeah. You get the scramble, and then you get the doink off the helmet for a pick six.
That punt, which, by the way, does not go into the books as a blocked punt, since Donald's foot never touched it. Drop here by Bennett. Goes into the books as a... So Boykin, who made a great play, doesn't even get credit for a blocked punt. Shoot, that's going to probably cost him $8-9 this next contract.
Yeah, that wouldn't be good. It wouldn't be good. There's nothing good out here for the Chicago Bears. Jay Cutler, I really would like to hear your opinion of why this has not worked out with Jay Cutler. This has not worked out in Chicago the way they thought it would.
Well, this is carried. I used the word enigmatic before. I mean, that would be, the best description of Cutler. I mean, we've seen him through the years going back to Denver, and you know, comes in with Mike Shanahan and then has the falling out with Josh McDaniels, winds up getting traded to Chicago. He's going to be the next Sid Luckman, you know, or Jim McMahon. And we see him, and he can look so good, and he can look so terrible. So, you know, what are you going to get? Which Jay do you get? Do you get the good Jay, the bad Jay? Well, we know what we've got tonight. Well, it's not all his fault. That defense was horrendous. He got crossing in. Sam Barrington came barreling in for the sack.
Well, you've seen Clay Matthews do this all night. Just going to shoot right through the gap. Nobody there to get him. And takes down Jimmy Clausen. You know, those are the kind of plays, I think, to guys like Peyton Manning and Kurt Warner and some of those guys, that if you blitz those guys, you paid a heavy price for that. And the great quarterbacks in the game, and I'm not talking about Jimmy Clausen, obviously he's not, doesn't have that kind of experience, but, you know, the really great ones have a way of, when you attack, you pay a heavy price. And so far, to at least in this one, the Chicago Bears haven't come close to making them pay a price for anything.
That was a fourth down play on a 12-yard sack, so Green Bay takes over on downs. And here's DeLon Harris. What's going on around the league? The Cardinals beat the Rams 31-14. 8-1 are the Arizona Cardinals, who are trying to become the first team to play a Super Bowl in its own stadium. Sean Payton, first home loss. What a crazy game that was. Big fourth down completion from Kaepernick. They go to overtime. Then there's a fumble, turnover. Harbaugh goes for the win on a Dawson field goal, which was one of the worst looking kicks I ever saw, but it was good from 35 yards out to win the game. He kicked a screwball knuckleball, but it went through. And, of course, then there's Peyton Manning. What else is new? Ninth game with five or more touchdown passes as they roll over the winless Oakland Raiders.
If somebody from the AFC had never been colder. Oh, yeah, you haven't been in this stadium often enough.
Yeah.
But if somebody invades the party, the Tom Brady, Peyton Manning, AFC championship game party, who do you think it is this year?
Set it up. Putting my thinking cap on. Very tough thing to do. At this point in the game. Third and one. Now you got Harris. pretty good on the statues by the time this one is done.
And
I'm not discounting San Diego. I know that was a terrible game they played against Miami, but you watch.
There you go, picking with your heart again. The Colts are pretty good. You know, we thought the Steelers after last week, and then, you know, nobody can hold on to this thing. Nobody seems to be able to really step up and say, all right, we're going to be the team. Kansas City, maybe. I just don't know. I mean, it's hard to imagine at this point it's not those two guys going at it again.
Up back is Coon. Well, if you could just keep your Bengals from going out after sundown, you might be okay in Cincinnati, too.
Primetime Warriors, they're not.
Oh, boy. Bears, second team to allow consecutive 50 points or more in a game. The Rochester Jeffersons. Oh, yeah. Come on down. 1923.
Wow.
In the history of the league.
There's a guy right there. Lance Briggs, probably his last game for the Bears in this stadium, and what a shame it has to go out like this. He was telling us that they sort of have a group text between Urlacher and Briggs and Hunter Hillemeyer and some of his old teammates. He says, it's my therapy, and we're going to need a lot of it. They may want to invite Dr. Phil to that group therapy session after this one. Great, great player. Just has not really worked out for him the last couple of years. Some of the injuries. We asked him, I said, how close is this team to the team that the defense Lovey ran? And he just says, it's not. It's just not. It's not the same style. It's not the same technique. It's not the same passion for turnovers that this team. I mean, Lovey's team's set records for turnovers, and that's really what they did. They made you go the long way, and then Peanut Tillman or Tim Jennings or Urlacher or Briggs or somebody would knock that football out if you had to go 10, 12 plays on a drive, and that has not been the case this year.
Well, Lovey has his own problems in Tampa Bay. Team that's won one game this season. This is going to take us to the two-minute warning. And we are finally there. 2 minutes to go. 55-14. Green Bay Packers. Volkswagen post-game report. We can tell you Michelle is going to have Aaron Rodgers and Clay Matthews on the field. Bob, Tony, Mike. Breaking it down, finding out what else is going on around the NFL, and we will take a look ahead to next week when the Patriots meet the Colts. Each of those teams coming off a bye week.
Now, you would think that would be a great game, right? We're going to get a great game next week.
We are due for a great game.
I promise you, that is going to be a great game.
We are due for a beauty.
And for all our military friends around the world, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Amen, ditto. Second and three. Coon to the six. So the Bears go home. Five of their last seven are at home, including five of the next six, and then they finish on the road. Packers stay here. Good game here next week. Philadelphia at Green Bay.
Mel Tucker, the defensive coordinator, I asked him about having to be a coach during the course of a losing streak. And he said, you pay cash. And I said, what? He said, you pay cash. You put down a credit card. They know who you are. And you got to listen to it. So you just pay cash.
Some merchants might not even take the cash tomorrow.
Not that I know.
Here's Coon. And this will take us down under a minute. Been a great night for the Green Bay Packers, top to bottom. Aaron Rodgers, six touchdowns. Mike McCarthy came up with a great plan, as he almost always does. And the Pack will go to 6-3. And the Bears go to the reverse.
19.
And here's Harris, and he's going to get the first down to the 2-yard line. So Harris getting a lot of action tonight. It's eight carries for him for 52 yards, and that's going to take us to the end of the game.
Almost feel sorry for Mark Trestman. Yeah. He's a good man. He's a good coach. And this is going south.
Yeah, this will be a rough week in the Windy City. And a great night in Green Bay. 55-14. Volkswagen Postgame Report. Next.